Let's start with our top story, though. AFL legend Eddie Baird says he isn't safe even in his own home after posting CCTV of a driver shouting racial abuse towards his children.
Live now to Today Melbourne reporter Isabella Stashkovsky. Isa, this has shocked not just the AFL community, but everybody who's seen it.
Yeah, Jane, good morning to you. The video is a little over 30 seconds long and it really is confronting. There's been an outpouring of messages already on social media. People just in disbelief that someone would actually behave in this way. In that vision, you can see that his kids and their friends are simply playing basketball out the front of their home. Someone then drives by. It appears to be a male voice repeatedly yelling out a racist slur that we won't repeat on air. Eddie Betts has chosen to share this vision. He's written a post as well. It reads, "Aboriginal kids deserve to be able to play safely, free from racism and abuse over the fence. We are not even safe in our own homes. If you know who this is, please let me know that I'm open to having a chat about how much this hurts our kids." So many comments there already in shock, in support of him as well. But of course, just such a horrible thing for him to have to share this Good Friday.
Isa Stashkovsky there, thank you. China has dropped crippling tariffs on Australian wine, reopening the door to what was once a billion-dollar industry.
Live with more to Nine federal politics reporter Amanda Kopp. Amanda, good morning. What does this mean for winemakers?
Good morning. Well, it's certainly a happy Easter for Australia's winemakers today, with China officially dropping all tariffs on the trade. Now, it's a big deal because China is the largest market for Australian wine exporters. The industry was worth $1.1 billion in 2019, but was shut down almost overnight when China slapped those taxes of more than 200% on back in 2020. At the time, it was widely seen as a response to then Prime Minister Scott Morrison calling for an international investigation into the origins of COVID-19. China also slapped on trade tariffs to Australian beef, timber, barley and lobster. And at its worst, federal government ministers couldn't even pick up the phone to their Chinese counterparts. But today, it's looking a lot better and those winemakers across the country are breathing a big sigh of relief.
Amanda Kopp in Canberra, thank you.
Two drivers are in hospital this morning after a car crashed into another that had broken down on the Gold Coast. The Dodge coming to a halt near traffic lights in Southport overnight before a Mercedes-Benz ran up the back. Both drivers were taken to Gold Coast University Hospital. And another driver has been taken to hospital after crashing into the back of a parked car also in Southport. The hatchback rolling after colliding with the stationary ute before it was pushed back onto its wheels. Victorian police have been left frustrated and disappointed after a major intersection in Melbourne CBD was brought to a halt. With no prior notice, hundreds of pro-Palestinian demonstrators gathered on Flinders Street, blocking traffic in all directions as people head away for the Easter long weekend. No arrests have been made. An attacker is on the run after a young man was stabbed in the stomach in a social media sale gone wrong in Perth. Police say the buyer and seller met in Hyde Park yesterday morning to exchange jewellery advertised on Facebook Marketplace. An argument broke out and the jewellery was swiped before the thief pulled out a knife and allegedly stabbed that seller. Three men are behind bars this morning accused of a string of armed robberies across Brisbane. Police swooping in after the gang allegedly tried to break into homes for a second day in a row. The men were first spotted in balaclavas wielding an axe across Paddington, Hamilton and Jindalee on Tuesday, later resurfacing on Wednesday before officers tracked them down to the city's north.
I could see that they were pulling a woman's hat over their face, one of the perpetrators or potential perpetrators, and were pulling, maybe a ski mask or something like that from their neck upwards.
No charges have been laid. A man is fighting for life this morning after he was discovered badly injured in Melbourne's east. Residents of a Baldwin home finding the man in their backyard around 9 p.m. Police are looking into whether he was assaulted and are asking for witnesses or anyone who might have heard something to come forward. The AFL's A-team club CEOs have been summoned in a snap meeting to discuss its illicit drugs policy after shock claims that players were told to cover up positive tests by faking injuries. Leaders were told information will be sent out to clubs in the next week to clarify the policy, while the notion that 100 players were granted secret immunity from the three strikes policy was rubbished. A new and improved policy will come into effect next year and will include AFLW players. A McDonald's worker who was attacked while on the job in the New South Wales Hunter region is calling on the fast food giant for better security. Five teenagers unleashing on Kobe Dawson at the Raymond Terrace venue 2 weeks ago, leaving the 22-year-old bloodied and needing stitches.
Threatening me, saying, do you want to fight? I'd like to see a change to the policies and stuff, allowing us to lock the front doors to stop like a whole crowd of people coming in when we have limited staff on.
Six teenagers aged 13 to 17 have been charged and granted strict bail conditions ahead of their appearance in the Children's Court in May. Victoria's top prosecutor has decided they will not appeal the sentence of Luay Sako in a move that has devastated the family of his murder victim, Celeste Mano. Celeste was stabbed in November 2020 by her former co-worker, her family calling for mandatory life sentences for murderers after 39-year-old Sako received a 30-year sentence last month. Several Labor MPs have raised their concerns over the government's rushed deportation laws, with some backbenchers warning Prime Minister Anthony Albanese against overreaching. The rushed changes are aimed at preventing the release of around 170 additional detainees. The Reserve Bank and federal government are this morning being blamed for the cancellation of popular music festival Splendour in the Grass. That's according to Australian music industry titan Peter Noble. Speaking to News Corp, the Byron Bay Blues Fest founder says he's calling on Australians to let the government know, quote, enough is enough. Well, crowds are building at seafood markets across the country with Easter long weekend celebrations in full swing. Live to Sarah Stewart, who is at the Sydney Fish Market. Sarah, good morning. The breakfast menu looking a little different this morning there.
Oh, it certainly is. I mean, there are prawns, there is calamari. Anything goes here for breakfast this morning. We're expecting 50,000 people to come through the doors over the next 4 days. It's a steady stream of people coming through here at the moment, but I am told between 8 and 11 today it is going to be the busiest. Now, I promised you I was going to find out some information on prices. I don't know the prices, but Gus, you're a trade expert. You know the prices. Tell us, what is good today? What are the bargains?
Look, there's not much that isn't good today, but we've been pleasantly surprised with the prices on offer this morning. And I'm looking to my right here and I'm seeing farm barramundi, you know, $15.99 a kilo. That is a magnificent price, whether we laughed or a larger one or the smaller ones that are directly behind me. All locally produced product, there's been an abundance of it, literally an abundance coming through all week. So I'm not surprised at all, but it's all the other
species. What about these
well.
Two?
Oh, the Balmain, the old Moreton Bay bug.
Okay.
Not to be confused with a Balmain bug. These are actually at the moment sitting somewhere between $20 to $30 less than what people would have paid for them at Christmas time. The simple reason is there's a lot of supply around, and there's been a lot since we've had those heavy rains, those flood rains in Queensland. The fishermen have gone out and literally found fields of these everywhere, so there wouldn't be anyone selling them for over $52 a kilo. At Christmas time, they were much more than that. The blue sumac crab, we're just so fortunate in Australia that we've got excellent fisheries, and these are whether it's New South Wales, but more so out of South Australia. That's where we're getting this product from. Again, great supplies all week. And again, the prices, I just can't keep talking about how great the prices are at the moment.
Awesome. Thank you, guys. I do love a bargain. You guys know that. And I just want to show you, look at the size of some of those prawns. Not bad, is it? If you want to come down, come on down.
Nice and red too, isn't it?
Yeah, juicy. Delicious. Oysters for breakfast. There were people tucking into all sorts of things.
I would totally do that.
You would?
Absolutely. Yep. Oh. It is never too early for some nice calamari.
We'll get you some.